before it's too late. Oh, there's coming a day when the party will be over. When your party will be over. And it's called Judgment Day. It's called Judgment Day. Oh, you need to get right before it's too late. Get right before it's too late. Oh, turn from your sin. The Bible says that no drunkard will inherit the kingdom of God. No drunkard, you will not inherit the kingdom of God. You need to repent. You know, in verse 11 it says, and such were some of you. That means you can stop being a drunkard. That means you can stop being a homosexual. That means you can stop being a reviler, an extortioner. That means you can stop being a liar and a thief. You can stop being greedy. And you can stop hating people. You can stop all of these sins. You can stop it. But do you want to? Are you willing? Are you willing to give your life over to Jesus? Oh, you need to be willing. You need to be willing. God's not going to force you, but God's going to hold you accountable. God's not going to make you saved. God's not going to make you saved. But if you're not saved, you're condemned. If you're not saved, you're condemned. Oh, you need to be saved from your sin. Jesus Christ came to this earth to die on the cross so that we might be forgiven. But why did Jesus Christ come to this earth? Jesus Christ came to save us from our sin. To save us from our sin. He didn't just come to save us from hellfire. You know, he doesn't want a bunch of sinners in heaven. Oh no! Jesus Christ came to save us from our sin. And if we're saved from our sin, it's only a consequence that we're saved from hellfire. That's just a consequence of being saved from your sin. If you're not saved from your sin, you're not saved from hellfire. If you still have sins on your record, you're still going to hell. I don't care if you go to church every week. I don't care if you go to church twice a week. If you die in your sin, you're going to go straight to hell. All that church going will be for naught if you don't get the sin out of your life. Oh, don't just go part way. You know, God doesn't want you part way. He doesn't want you to just show up for the assembly. Jesus Christ doesn't want you just to show up and sing the pretty songs. Jesus Christ doesn't want you to show up and put money in the offering plate. He doesn't want you in part. He doesn't want you in chunks. Jesus Christ wants all of you, my friend. He wants all of you. He wants all of your mind. He wants all of your heart. And he wants all of your strength. And he is worthy of it. And he's worthy. All as long as you continue in your sin, you're just fooling yourself. You're just fooling yourself. You're not fooling God. God sees right through you. God sees right through you. And the burning, flaming eyes of God are peering at you right now. The burning, flaming eyes of God are staring right through you right now. Oh, you need to give an account for your life. You need to give an account for your life. If you die in your sin, you're going to burn in hell for your sins. Make no mistake about it. Make no mistake about it. You're going to get what you deserve unless you repent. You're going to get what you deserve in hell forever unless you repent. Unless you change your heart, unless you change your mind, you're going to get what you deserve. Oh, I don't want you to get what you deserve. I want you to receive the grace of God that bringeth salvation, which has appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we shall live soberly and righteously and godly in this present world. Oh, you need the salvation. You need the grace of God that leads us to stop sinning and follow Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ would never lead you to get drunk. So if you get drunk, you're not following Jesus, now are you? Jesus Christ is not going to lead you to have sex outside of marriage. Oh no! Jesus Christ would lead you to wait until you get married. You need to follow Jesus Christ. And follow Jesus Christ every day and all day. Oh, it's a battle. We're in a fight for our lives. And the enemy wants to kill us. The Bible says that the enemy was seek to steal and to kill and to destroy. Oh, stop listening to the enemy. Stop listening to the devil. The devil wants you to sin because he wants to steal, he wants to kill, and he wants to destroy you. Oh, I guarantee you this, you are a slave. Everyone in this world is a slave. Either you're a slave to the devil or you're a slave unto God. And both slaveries are willing. If you're a slave unto the devil, it's because you chose it. If you're a slave unto God, it's because you chose it. But the difference between the two is that the devil hates you and God loves you. I'd rather be a slave to God who loves me, who's a lover of my soul. Oh, but most of you are listening to the devil who hates your very guts, who wants you to die and go to hell just like him. Oh, that's right. The devil's going to burn in hell too. He's not getting out of it. He's going to burn in hell too. Why, oh, why would you burn in hell with the devil?